Live on tape, it's That City Show with your hosts, Eric Crosslin and Barry Levy, plus Ann Arnold-Ogden on news. Today's guests, Bobby Haggerman and Charlotte Dameron. And now, the man Chuck Norris fears the most, Eric Crosslin.
Don't you dare say that.
I
did not say that, Chuck. There's no way. Can you imagine?
He lives like in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, I think.
Yeah,
he?
You know, I used to work at a bar called the Wild Turkey in downtown-ish Dallas, and they all those guys that used to work on his show, Walker, Texas Rangers, the set builders would come in afterwards to drink, and man, they had stories. That guy was just as cool in real life as the myths say.
They weren't all beat up. Now.
Yeah.
No.
Bear.
Eric's going to have to go into hiding now.
Oh, my Lord.
Who is it?
Chuck Norris.
No, Chuck Norris doesn't knock me. He karate kicks through the door. All right, first off, real quick, what was I going to do? I am Eric Crosslin, host, and when I get nervous, I put my hands right here and then I sniff them.
That's illegal.
Go ahead, Barry.
And I am Barry Levy, public information officer for the City of Wichita Falls, and once in a while, I have been accused of being hip.
Once in a while. When? Once in a great while.
Truth. I think when I was two.
I'm Ann Arnold-Ogden, Community Marketing Director with the Wichita Falls Chamber of Commerce.
And girls, they wanna have fun.
Oh.
Can you make me an emoji?
What do you want to be? Oh, you want a smiling
like
little thing
girl
in your
emoji.
Hand? Okay.
I love your glasses last time.
I'll show you later. We'll
okay,
share.
You okay. Text me the emoji you want, and I'll put it on there. Like a Ms. Pac-Man? Like, how do we know it's a girl? It has a bow? It's kind of sexist.
I'll send you the text.
Okay. All right.
We're always looking for ways to make Eric work harder.
Yeah, absolutely. Everything
is always like, more.
Not
bad.
Not
emoji
working hard enough.
Yeah, that's when I got that right. Well, hey, listen, we've been going like super long on our shows lately. Super duper long. Yeah. So I want to go ahead and just
it's
get on
into
it.
It's a great show.
So you're cutting all the songs?
There won't be a song today. Only City Biz. Just I want to give a break. Just a break today. I have been getting a lot of comments out in the real world about
I haven't heard
these
anything
songs.
Negative.
Oh, really? Because they've been really negative to
my
me.
My kids love it. They
I've got
love
quit
it.
Singing. I've got stop singing on TV.
They have the book out, Singing for Dummies.
Yes. So, but seriously, we got a great show today. Okay. We've got Bobby Haggerman here. We're going to show a little video of a little something he did with us earlier. And we got Char.
Char.
But first, we will do City Biz, and Barry, we do have a City Biz song. City Biz. Wait, how did it go again? City Biz, for you and me and everyone. City Biz, Barry makes it so much fun.
That's great.
I say so much fun, then it's like, Zika virus is invading our
hands. Yeah, people are getting arrested last week. Okay.
I gotta do something real quick.
All right, here you go, Barry.
City Biz. My daughter said,
oh my gosh,
she said,
what is happening?
She said, Dad, if you're going to do City Biz, you need to look like a news anchor.
You look like Justin Bieber.
Oh, no.
The one person I would not want to look like. I would rather
you
look
like that is what Justin Bieber looks like.
There. That's fixing a little bit.
Am I close to a news anchor at all? No?
I'm the you're right next to one that used to be.
I'm the creepy guy at the mall then. Right, or Walmart?
Right. Now, that was before any of this, though.
That's just...
I didn't need the wig. You didn't need the wig.
Oh,
I love it, Barry.
Okay, thank my daughter.
Best thing you've ever done.
I've got pictures of her.
I don't believe your daughter had anything to do with it.
Where did you
I'll show
this
you.
Wig?
I do. I'm sorry?
Where did this wig come from?
Amy's
the prop
into cosplay.
Closet.
Amy's into cosplay, and she's got like 20 wigs.
Okay.
All kinds.
And what character was she cosplaying when she put this
I can't tell. I don't know the names of them because they're like really long and complicated, so I don't know.
What did Justin Bieber's fans call it again?
Believers?
Believers?
She still knows. Look at Ann. What a nerd.
Okay.
All right, Ann.
Now that I've got my anchor hair, I will put on my anchor voice. We are talking. Talking.
No, you've already messed up. You have to say, excuse me, talking.
Okay. We have talked about this before, recycling, and the city does a tremendous amount of recycling, and I would encourage everybody to go to the city website, WichitaFallsTX.gov, and go to the sanitation page, and there's a whole area dedicated to the recycling programs that we have, but there is also, on the very front page, right below where it says Keep It Green, there's a little section that we placed on there. I love that music, it's kind of exciting. Russell Schreiber, the Public Works Director, did a presentation for the City Council about how involved the city's recycling programs are, what we do, how we do it, the pros and cons of different programs. And so I would encourage everybody to go to the Wichita Falls webpage, website, go to sanitation and click on Russell's presentation. It'll download for you. It's a PowerPoint, and it'll explain a lot, answer a lot of questions. And
this is about recycling? I wasn't listening.
Recycling.
Okay. We do recycle.
And I'm going to run through this really quick.
Okay.
We recycle newspaper, cardboard, glass, yard waste, food waste, metal, computers, tires, and
hair.
Old That City shows.
No, those get thrown in a landfill, never to be seen again.
Bury it deep. And we do recycle plastics. There are seven types. We only do number one and number two, plastics. There are seven categories. I just said that. Of the plastics, here's what we will take with the lids removed. We will do Coke bottles, water bottles, salad dressing bottles, peanut butter containers, milk jugs, juice bottles, shampoo bottles, and detergent containers with the lids removed.
Wow.
We recycle.
City biz for you and me and everyone. City biz. Barry makes it so much fun.
Back to normal.
All right. We're going to go ahead and take a commercial break. Coming up, oh, I don't have to look. I remember. It's Bobby Haggerman. He's from Weeks Park. He's going to tell us all about tennis,
awesome.
How he whipped up on Jimmy Connors
up
in the day. I almost retired him. I might be I think I'm embellishing a little bit, but we'll hear about it straight from the man himself. When we come back
made
with
cry.
That city show.
He made
me
cry.
It's always bad, and I guess it's embarrassing. Come on.
City show. If you were just joining us, Barry, well, you had hair, and it's gone
back
again.
Back to normal.
Here today, gone tomorrow. Hair today, gone.
Been gone a long time.
Yeah, you and me both. Well, mine's been slowly. It's been slow and torturous for the last 12 years. I just wish it had woken up and it was all gone.
That's what mine. I just woke up one day and I was, oh.
Joining us, gosh, what, fourth, fifth week in a row? Ann Arnold-Ogden.
Why do you always sound surprised?
Because if I was you, I would not be here. I'd be heading for the hills.
I'm glad to be here.
Thanks, Ann. We're glad to have
fun.
You to
Everyone's
another state.
Like, those guys, you know? And I'm like, no, it's just, it's really, it's fun. Come on the show and find out for yourself.
Now, you're going to be a floating head today because you wore black and you're against a black curtain. At least from my viewpoint, you're a floating head. So keep that in mind. Don't move around too much. Joining us now, all the way from the Weeks Park Tennis Center. Bobby Haggerman, everybody. Yay! There he is.
Awesome.
Hey. Bobby, you want to give us your name and your title and your three-second pose to that camera right there, sir?
Sure. I'm Bobby Haggerman. I'm the director and head pro at Weeks Park Tennis Center.
Can I be your tennis ball?
That might be the best one.
You put a
yet.
Slice on that.
Bobby,
little spin.
You did play Jimmy Connors, and instead of letting you tell the story yourself, you've told it here in this building before, and I'm just going to play real quick an animated little.
You made Jimmy cry.
So you might want to turn
Should
around.
Should I turn around and watch
Yeah, you turn around and watch it. You've seen this before.
Bobby Haggerman, tennis professional at Weeks Park. Great to have you here. We're real excited to be talking tennis. Got to ask you about your playing career. Did you play against Jimmy Connors?
I did. In fact, I was ahead of him in the first set, and his mother started to freak out. And I realized, golly, I'm beating the number one in the nation. And then it flipped.
There you go. That was it. Was my animation accurate? Is that what it actually looked like?
Yes.
Oh, holy moly. Here we go. We're going to make you watch yourself on a loop.
Like Eric has at his house.
I have this switch where the curtains close and the sexy Thousands music comes on, and then I come on TV. Yeah, nothing creepy about that. Bobby, so tell us all about the Weeks Park Tennis Center. Tell us about the lessons you offer. Tell us, just get some people down there.
Well, Weeks Park Tennis Center is one of the two municipal facilities here in Wichita Falls. And we have programming for adults and kids. We have league play. We run tournaments. So, you know, if somebody wants to be in a group lesson or in a private lesson, we can take care of them, no matter whether they've ever hit a ball or not.
Like somebody doesn't have friends, they don't have to come in a group?
No, they could come have a private lesson.
Good.
And if someone's just starting out, they don't need to go try to buy a racket. We even have loaner rackets they can use
Sweet.
To start out. Because, you know, rackets are, there's so many different choices. One man's trash is another man's treasure, and then we can recommend something after they we've seen how they hit the ball.
That was the name of my first album, by the way. One man's trash is another man's treasure. Out there on Empire Records. So, Bobby, you are one of the instructors out there. You do some of the teaching. Now, speak to some of the benefits of playing tennis. It's anaerobic. It's stop and start.
Oh, my gosh. They say that tennis really may be one of the best things that people can do throughout their life and as they age. When you play a stimulating game of doubles, it establishes new neuron pathways in your brain.
What the?
And you know, tennis, moving around a tennis court is very acrobatic too. So, you know, even for those as they get older, it helps them maintain balance and keeps them healthy.
Keeps you agile.
And another part of tennis exercise is interval based, because right. you run, then you rest in between points for 10, 15 seconds, and you run. And the medical experts, health experts now say that interval based exercise is really the best for your body.
Well, yeah, because the runner, you know, when you're just getting plod along for three miles, you know, that starts really banging on your knees and whatnot.
Right.
But like you say, you run, you do that point, and then like if you win, and then you just wait for the other chump to get the ball and serve it back to you, and then you play again.
Right.
Yeah. So
our kids took tennis lessons from you. They had a great time and they loved it. So
well, we try to keep it fun. You know, somebody's got to be learning and acquiring skills. But if it isn't fun, what's the point?
Yeah. Exactly. And how would people get a hold of you, Bobby, if they
wanted
to?
Well, our phone number
is... And if you've got a gesture.
Okay, our phone number is 940...
Overhand smash.
322-7700.
Wow, that one's going to be cool. All right, Barry's got a prop and a question, Barry.
Oh, no, I'm just ready for my lesson.
Well, if you want to find Weeks Park Tennis Center, I've got another little thing up here. You can just look for the... this guy right here. Let me just pop this up.
Oh, surprise.
Well, no, not really. I've got a quick story, though, Barry.
People the easiest way to find it.
Uh-huh. Look for this thing.
Exactly.
Like, is that
exactly
what you're going to say?
Yeah, that's part of it. There's probably 70% of the people in Wichita Falls don't know Weeks Park Tennis Center exists.
I'd say 71, but look at your facts. I don't know.
It's, you know, you have to really know where it is.
Yeah.
You know, our sister facility, people see it as they go down the boulevard.
Right.
And
tough to get to this guy.
It's across the street from the Arbor Creek Apartments.
That's
a
right.
lot of people know where those are.
Right.
And if you're on Midwestern and you're coming down past Taft and it curves around, you turn right on Weeks Park Lane. And then the entrance is about 500 feet. It's on the left. You go over a little one-lane bridge, and we're right across the creek and the street from the Arbor Creek Apartments.
The other thing I really enjoy about the tennis in Wichita Falls is it is probably the least expensive,
right,
most affordable sporting activity that you can do. Tell us
yes,
about the...
Yes, you can. If someone wants to just come in and try it, there's a $3 court fee. We'll let them borrow some of our teaching balls. We'll loan them a racket if they need it. We have a backboard. We have a ball machine that we rent out. And so, you know, it's a deal. It really is. When you look in major metro areas, the cost of playing even at public facilities is three or four times higher.
Yeah, you compare that to golf, where it's like $300 just to get on the court. Is that what they call the golf court? Golf court.
Are these standard issue?
What? The
headbands?
Oh, headbands are a good
They're
deal.
Okay.
They look good. It looks good. Please. Well, I don't know what said that. Bobby, anything else you want to get about? We know you got to run to some things. You're an important man. You got to go whip up on Jimmy Connors again. Does he still play? Anything else at all you want to get out about Weeks Park before we move along?
Well, I'd like to say this. The Wichita Falls Tennis Association hosts 5 major tournaments a year.
Well, I don't believe you.
And we have the largest of those tournaments coming up March 12th through the 14th. And
how many people do you think?
We have 393
Whoa.
Players entered from all over the state, boys and girls, 16 and 18 and under. And it's the very top super champ division. So if people want to come watch some Boy. Really good tennis, we're going to be using 9 sites around the county to run the tournament.
Fantastic.
So, and it's not only is it good tennis to come watch, and it's good for our local players to be able to play the tournament here without having to go out of town, but it's a great thing for the city's economy. We're going to be filling up the hotels. All the restaurants will be busy. It's
nice.
A win-win.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Great.
I think Bobby could beat Chuck Norris at tennis.
Oh, Barry, you don't know what you're getting into with all this.
Okay. All I'm right. confident.
Well, Bobby, thank you so much for stopping by. And we're going to take a short break, and we come back. Charlotte Dameron. I'm saying your last name wrong, aren't I?
Yes.
Was that yes, it's right or yes, it's wrong?
Dameron. There you go.
When we come back with more of That City Show.
Hey. history we've had a guest just leave.
Just disappear.
Bobby was done.
I shot out of here.
Yeah, you didn't see off air. Chuck Norris kicked through the door, threw him out there. I picked up Chuck, broke him over my... I'm just kidding, Chuck. If you're just joining us, of course Barry Levy's here. Of course the lovely and talented Ann Arnold-Ogden. I can't say it without seeing the dash, Ann. It's here. And now joining us, Charlotte Dameron.
Yay!
From TRN.
That's right.
And here to promote the upcoming book fair. If you want to go ahead and give us your name and your title and your three-second pose, please.
I am Charlotte Dameron. I'm with the Times Record News, but I am on here on behalf of the Wichita Adult Literacy Council.
Oh. Oh, that was a cute little pose. All right, so tell us all about this. What is literacy? What is that? I don't even understand that word.
Literacy is just many things. Just the knowledge of literacy is one thing. Everybody thinks of literacy as knowing how to read,
right,
and write.
Is there more to it?
There is so much more to it. There's health literacy, computer literacy, financial literacy, family literacy.
We have none of those.
We have all of those at literacy. Council, though.
Do you have broadcast literacy?
I heard that Barry was going to be teaching a class on that very soon. We'll get you hooked up over there.
I like that.
But, Wichita Adult Literacy Council has been here for about 30 years, and that's what they deal with, literacy. Yeah. And they work one-on-one with students, adult students, to teach them how to read and write and health and family and financial. Everything.
What are some of the comments you get from people who have not been able to read, and then they go through your programs and boy, now they can read?
You know, it's really interesting. It's kind of a mixed bag. We have our people who don't want anyone knowing. It's very taboo for many.
Sure.
And that's completely understandable. But we have some that go on to become our tutors and our board members. We have one member who's been through our program and ended up working at MSU for many, many years in an administration type of role. But now she's on our board. And so she is one of our mouthpieces for us. It quite literally does change people's lives. And I don't think people realize that this service is available free of charge to the adults, one-on-one with a tutor. You're not going to get that anywhere else. So it's pretty amazing.
You guys must have to fundraise in order to provide that service.
We have a lot of fundraising, actually. Thank you, Anne, because that brings me to our next project. WALK has two fundraisers a year. And for an organization of that size, that's not a lot of fundraisers. So this year we're really hoping to reach out and raise some money for literacy. And by that, in order to do that, we are hosting a book fair. This is actually...
Sweet. I used to love those when I was a kid.
Yeah,
this is one of my favorite events entire year in Wichita Falls. I love the book fair. I really, and I read all the time anyway, so...
It is so much fun.
It is a nerd
People magazine,
dream
Vogue.
To go
I like
to
read. I like
Popular
to read
Mechanics.
Too.
Yeah, it's so much fun. This is the 16th year for the book fair. They currently have about 70,000 books that have all been donated by people in the community. People just drop off books at the Literacy Council. It's crazy. So, if you want to find a book about how to grow hair in 90 days.
You have one of those?
I've got some.
I'm there.
That just sold two tickets.
Just done.
Hot dog.
You know, we've got it. Pretty much any kind of book you want, they have.
It's great, too. There are lots of vintage books. Like, I love home decorating, which is nerdy also, but you can find those vintage decor books from the 50s and 60s books that are vintage.
Cookbooks.
I mean, there's just cookbooks.
The cookbooks, made by families from the 40s and 50s and 60s are always my favorite because you get the interesting recipes and things. So any kind of book you want, you can get. They're all sorted. They spend a year sorting all these books into 40 different genres. So it's all nicely laid out. So many books.
It's coming up.
It is coming up.
Next week. Hold on.
Yeah, March 10th and 11th and 12th.
Okay.
And time and place?
Sykes Lake Center on the MSU campus.
Been there.
Uh-huh. Thursday night is very exciting because it is their preview night. It is when all the big book lovers come in. That is an admission a night. So it's $5 for the ticket for that. So make sure you get your tickets.
You get first dibs on all the books.
Yeah.
All the books.
Those, yeah.
All of them.
I could see maybe a fight breaking out if two people are reaching for the same book.
We have booksellers.
If you're going to get in a fight, it's those book nerds. Yeah.
There are booksellers from Dallas that come to our book fair to buy books because
is this like a black market?
Yeah. They're cheap. They are $2 for a hardback and $1 for a paperback.
Holy moly.
And the good majority of these books are still top current bestseller books. So you can go to the store and buy it for $20, right, or you can come and donate $2.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm seeing a hot date.
Yes.
I'm seeing a hot date.
Oh, what
go
a great
buy some books
night.
And then go play some tennis.
Well, you could watch the sunset at the Sights Lake
You can. It's a beautiful space, nice. Beautiful window.
And you make your move when she's reading her book.
Get a romance novel.
Get a romance novel.
There are a lot of copies of 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, hold on now. Hold on now.
What section is that again?
But yeah, there's so many books that Thursday night is an admission night. Friday and Saturday are free.
Yeah.
But this is, they would like to raise $20,000. All of that goes directly to help the Literacy Council teach these adults how to read.
And that helps our community.
$20,000, you can do it.
Huge. And let me give you a statistic about our community, actually.
Oh.
The effects of low literacy cost the United States $235 billion each year in productivity in the workforce. So that is loss of revenue, tax revenue, due to unemployment or people who cannot effectively work in the work.
Yeah.
And
in the world.
In the world.
But, in America.
But ultimately, that's one in four people in the Texoma region, one in four adults.
Goodness.
And so I don't know which one of us cannot read. But that's you.
Yes.
And that's you not being able to work,
right,
and provide for your family. But it's also you not being able to sign papers for your children's school.
Oh, my goodness.
Maybe even put gas in your car.
All right.
So it's a lot. And 16% of the world's population is non-literate, and the lowest level of that, two-thirds of those are women.
I can only read English, though. I can't read those other languages.
You're not a woman. So.
Okay. You're not even in the
country. Finally,
but
somebody.
Yeah,
it is fun. It's a great event.
It's a great event.
An organization that helps so many people in our area.
Yeah, well, do we need any contact info from you? How can
yes,
people get a hold of you? Could
if you
gesture
questions,
to the camera?
If you have questions, you can call the Literacy Council at 940-766-1954. You can find them online.
I'll shoot it out your finger there.
Find them online at wfwalc.org, and they have a brand new website, which is beautiful. So.
Awesome. Like, well, you think you're so smart, you know how to read. I'm going to test you real quick.
Oh, great. Thanks
all right.
so much.
What does that say on the screen behind you?
I have
you?
No idea.
Right on the screen right behind
oh,
you, what
I
does
should
that
look.
Say? Yeah.
That city?
Oh, she can read. Oh, my goodness. Wow. Go learn from her. She just proved it right here. Well, thank you so much, Charlotte. And that's
thank
a wonderful cause,
me.
And I hope you can raise all that money.
Let's do it. Let's
don't
do
go
it.
Anywhere. We're not taking a break. We're just sliding our attention on over here to Ann Arnold-Ogden, and she's going to tell us about Choose Wichita Falls.
All right, y'all ready?
Yes.
I'm looking at Barry's notes, and he says, get her coffee. She's been dozing off.
Oh, I saw that over there.
I would not be mad if you went and got me some real quick while I do.
I'm her fetching boy.
Ready, starting.
Boy, coffee.
Well, go.
Okay, MSU Theater starts this weekend. Lysistrata, I believe I am saying it correctly. Charlotte, can you back me up?
I don't understand any of these words.
I will
just
back
said.
You up on that because I really do not know.
It is set in ancient Greece, so that's what I know. And
you've been to ancient Greece.
Couple he's a time traveler.
Wait, this is the name of the play that you just
Lysistrata,
said?
Lysistrata, I believe is how you pronounce it. It's probably not, but I've been going around all over town saying that.
Nobody else knows.
That's Estrada? What it's called. Yeah.
Eric Estrada.
Eric Estrada with lice.
Tickets are just $5 to $10. It's free for students, faculty, and staff at MSU. So go out and support those budding theater folks. They grew up to become me and Charlotte.
That's right.
So, that's right. So go out and support them.
We end up in marketing.
Yeah.
You're training your future marketers,
yeah.
people.
The Wichita Falls Nighthawks coming Friday. Back home to face off against the Colorado Crush. We also have the Express.
Colorado Crush, what a dumb name.
Totally.
Crush.
They'll crush them.
Colorado cowards.
The Express Half Marathon is coming up. I can't talk. That's on Saturday. They bill this as the flattest, fastest course in the area.
So okay.
Helps a lot of organizations. Kids Fish and Rodeo
it
this
is tough.
Weekend.
Yes, it's finally
Parks
here.
And Recreation coming
Go
up
out and
at
see Holly.
Plum yep. Lake. Is she going to come on and talk about it?
We've talked about it a bunch with her.
Okay. Yep.
That's one of her big things is like fishing rodeo.
Y'all, it's Dr. Seuss's birthday.
Ride those fish.
Hello.
Today? Today?
No.
Oh.
Well, maybe, but no. Dr. Seuss's birthday party at the library on Saturday. This coming Saturday, it is free and there will be cake.
Practice your reading up over
always,
there.
Always, always time for cake.
There is always time for
always
cake.
Always time for cake. Opening this weekend, Disney's 101 Dalmatians
Yay.
For kids at the Wichita Theater. Oh, that's going
to
be fantastic.
My son is in that. Oh. You need to go see it. Yeah. Everybody
do they have go. Real puppies on there?
Yes, lots of them. They're so cute.
Seriously? Oh.
No, not real puppies on stage.
They're
the children,
still,
but
they're
lots
still
and
cute.
Lots of children
Wait,
from
so
this
on.
Community on stage.
There's 100 kids up there and dogs?
Approximately.
Sure, approximately. Approximately. You know, really,
That's
when
funny.
You get a couple of kids together, it feels like 100. So,
I wouldn't know.
She's a mom. She can say that.
Totally.
Yeah. Exploration into nature. They're going to be talking about snakes Saturday at Riverbend Nature
oh,
Center.
It's a cat.
Rock and Worship Roadshow oh. coming up at the Impact. They'll
there
have
you go.
Newsboys, Jeremy Camp, and more. And then... just throwing this out for the country fans, Kevin Fowler will be here Saturday as well.
Hot diggity.
Nice.
So many things.
One more. Red River Speedway is racing Friday and Saturday night.
Okay.
They're bringing in 130 teams, which means there's probably going to be about 160 to 180 cars, not racing at one time. But then each team brings about six people. So
okay.
you're looking at people from about six, seven different states. Big economic impact and some exciting racing.
Concessions, beer.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to race right down camp.
They're going to get there somehow. If you want to find out about any of these events or anything else going on in the area, log on to choosewichitafalls.com.
If you're
bored, it's your fault. Oh, here we go.
Yay.
So true.
That is.
Our unofficial tagline.
Oh, it is. We need sharks that say that. That's kind of sassy.
Bored?
If you're bored, then
it's your fault.
All right. That's it. We're... Oh, boy, we've gone over 30. Oh, yeah, Barry, what do you got there?
Chicharrones.
Chicharrones.
No, I got hungry a while ago.
He never shares, though. Can I have one?
Oh, you sure? They're spicy.
Okay.
Oh, riveting television here. All right.
People are just waiting for this at home.
Good crunch.
Yeah, there you go, Ann. It's awful dangerous to let me have raw footage of you doing that. All right. I'd like to say, on behalf of Bobby Haggerman, Charlotte Dameron. Did I say it right that time?
No.
Dameron.
Sure.
Dameron.
Charlotte Dameron.
Charlotte Dameron.
There you go.
Ann Arnold-Ogden. Barry Levy.
Nickname, Chicharrone.
Okay. And I am Eric Crosslin, and this has been That City Show.
Yay.